In this video, we will discuss atomic structure, its historical background, how the atomic structure was developed by the scientists. First of the scientists was Dalton. In 1808, he postulated that all matter is composed of the smallest unit called atom. And atoms are indivisible. They are the smallest units and they are indivisible. And hence they are the building blocks of all the metals. This was postulated by the scientist Dalton in 1808. Now, then it was a great scientist J.J.Thomson who discovered electrons to be a part of atom. How he discovered electrons? He was in an experiment with cathode ray tube. In cathode ray tube, what happened? There are two electrodes. One is cathode and one is anode. And inside the tube, air is at very low pressure to the tune of 10 raised to the power minus 3 millimeter pressure is kept inside the tube, and very high voltage around 1000 volt is applied to the electrodes of the tube, and there is a fluorescent plate placed at the back of the anode. Anode is perforated so that the rays coming from the cathode can pass through the anode. And there is fluorescent screen is zinc sulfide, which can detect the any of the particle striking zinc sulfide. We can detect the any of the particle striking the fluorescent plate zinc sulfide. Now, after passing this high voltage through a very low pressure, what was observed by J.J.Thomson in the year 1897? He found that some particles escape from cathode and they come towards anode. So there is a ray coming from cathode towards the anode, and that ray he called as cathode ray. And cathode ray is composed of the particles which are negatively charged. Why they are negatively charged? Because they are attracted towards the positively charged anode, or to make it sure, if we apply an electric field around this tube, we see that these ray particles, deflect towards the positive side of the electric field. If electric field is applied around this tube, we see Thomson observed that the ray particles are deflected towards the positive electric field. So it means that these particles are negatively charged. So these were the particles, because they could rotate the pedal wheel also. So it was pointed that these rays are composed of particles which are negatively charged. So the Thomson gave some properties of cathode ray particles, as they travel in a straight line, because if we place some opaque material in the middle of the path, we see that there is no passing through the, there is no rays coming to this side of the opaque material. So we conclude that they travel in straight lines independent of material of cathode. Whatever be the material of the cathode, the property of the cathode ray particles are same. So we say that they are independent of material of cathode. And cathode ray particles are negatively charged, we have just seen, by applying electric field, and also they are attracted towards positive anode. And Thomson measured E by M ratio, charge by mass ratio of for the electron, that came out as 1.76 into 10^11 coulomb per kilogram. And Millikan, another scientist, he calculated the value of charge on the electron, that was 1.60 into 10^-19 coulomb. And by these two values, E by M and E, we could calculate the mass of electron, that comes out to be 9.1 × 10^-31 kg. So these were the properties of cathode ray particles, which were called electrons. And this was how electrons were discovered. But if we see atom is a neutral particle, it does not have any charge. So if electrons are having negative charge, then there must, to counterbalance this negative charge, there must be some particles to cancel the effect of these negative charge. There must be some positive charge to cancel out this negative charge, so as to make the whole atom as neutral. So in this field, some experiments were carried out, and next the protons were discovered by a scientist called Goldstein in 1919. Discovery of proton took place. This is a cathode ray tube, and inside this hydrogen gas was placed between the two electrodes, and high voltage was applied, and here anode was positive, and we saw that there were some particles which are coming towards cathode was perforated, and the particle passed through the perforated cathode and make a spot on the fluorescent plate of zinc sulfide. So we observed what the Goldstein observed out of this experiment, that these particles are traveling in a straight line. They are positively charged because they are moving towards negatively charged cathode. And if we place electric field, then they will be deflected towards negative electric field. So, which proves that they are positively charged, and they are dependent on gas inside the tube. See, electrons, in case of electrons were coming out of the cathode plate. Electrons were coming out of the cathode plate, but these positively charged particles are not coming out of the anode, but they are the ions of the gas which is placed between the anodes, between the electrodes. So they are the ions of the gas, hydrogen in this case, hydrogen is ionized and it makes H plus ion, and these ions makes the proton. So these particles were dependent on the gas inside the tube, and they cast shadow of opaque objects. If we place an opaque object here, we see a shadow on the fluorescent screen. They cast shadow of opaque object, and they produce mechanical effect. Mechanical effect means if we place a pedal wheel in between the path of the particles, then pedal wheel start rotating. It means they are made up of particles and they produce mechanical effect. Then mass of the proton was discovered as 1.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 24 kg, and it is the mass which is 1840 times the mass of electron. And charge on proton was 1.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 19 coulomb, and this is a positive charge. This is same as that of electron. On electron it was negative charge, and on proton this is a positive charge. And E by M ratio was also calculated as 9.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 7 coulomb per kilogram. So these are the properties of proton, how the proton was discovered. Now, electrons were discovered, protons were discovered, but a problem still remained, because till then the atomic mass was not explained, because we knew that electrons don't have any mass, they are negligible, they are of negligible mass. Neutrons, protons have mass, but atomic mass of any atom was greater than the mass of the protons present in that atom. So it was thought that there must be some particles. Charge was neutralized. Positive charge on proton was neutralized by the negative charge of the electrons. Same quantity of charge, positive and negative. They were neutralized and atom was neutral. It was explained. But the mass of the atom was higher than the mass of the protons present in the atom. So it was thought there must be some particles which account for the difference in mass and which will be neutral, so that the whole atom shall remain neutral. So in this series, another particle of subatomic particle, neutron, was discovered by James Chadwick in the year 1932. He performed an experiment with the alpha particles. What are alpha particles? Alpha particles are helium atoms with two electrons removed. They are positively charged particle and their mass is equal to two proton. Alpha particles were made to pass through a plate of boron. This is boron or beryllium, any metal plate is placed between the alpha particles were bombarded on the boron plate. What happened? Some rays emerges out of the boron plate, and these particles were neutral. And they have very high energy particles, which when made to pass through wax, the protons shoot out from the wax. Means they have so much energy that after striking on the wax plate, they make protons to shoot out from the wax. So these neutral particles were called neutrons. They were neutral because if any electric field was applied, they were not deflected. So they were neutral atoms. There was no charge, neutral atoms, and their mass was found to be equal to that of proton, 1.67 into 10 raised to the power minus 24 kg. Mass was equal to that of proton. And by discovery of this subatomic particle, we could explain the atomic mass. Atomic mass was explained, and mass of neutron plus mass of photon was mass of the atom. So our all the subatomic particles of atom were discovered, and then Rutherford did a experiment with gold foil to find the structure of an atom. What does Rutherford did? What did Rutherford in his gold foil experiment? He take a very thin plate, thin foil of gold. Thin foil of gold. Since gold is a very malleable metal which can be converted into very thin sheet, he converted the gold into very thin foil, and he placed that thin foil before the alpha particles. Alpha particles were made to bombard on the thin foil of the gold. See, there is thin foil, but we have taken for our simplicity, I have taken one atom of the gold here. So what was observed by Rutherford? He found that most of the alpha particles, they pass through the thin foil. They pass through the thin foil, which means that most of the space inside an atom is empty. And other point he observed that few alpha particles, most of the alpha particles were undeflected and they passed through the thin foil. And second point was few of the alpha particles, they were slightly deflected. And third observation was very few alpha particles bounce back with an angle 180 degree. It is 1 in 20,000. If 20,000 alpha particles are there, that 1 in 20,000 alpha particles were bounced back, deflected through an angle 180 degree. So, with these observations, the conclusions drawn by the Rutherford was that most of the space inside the atom is empty. There is positive charge of the atom occupies very little space because the alpha particle which is repelled is very few, 1 in 20,000. So, the positive charge in the atom is very little, and that positive charge around is inside the atom, and around this positive charge, the most of the atom is empty. All the positive charge and mass is concentrated in a very small space within the atom, that is called nucleus. And radius of nucleus was 1 by 10 raised to the power 5 into radius of atom. Means radius of atom is very, very large than radius of nucleus. These positively charged center was called nucleus with all the mass of the atom. And he further postulated that the electrons revolve around the nucleus. Orbit, he did not postulated orbit because it was postulated by Bohr's afterwards. But this structure of Rutherford was having some drawbacks, and those drawbacks were very important drawbacks which could not be explained by Rutherford by his theory. So, what were those drawbacks? Drawbacks of Rutherford were that according to Maxwell theory, electromagnetic theory, that any charged particle when accelerated they radiate energy. They radiate electromagnetic waves in the form of, they radiate energy in the form of electromagnetic waves. And see, it was nucleus and electrons are moving. This is electron. This is moving around the nucleus. See, electron is a charged particle and it is moving in a circular path. Then we say that the charged particle is accelerating because its velocity is changing every time. When velocity is changing, the rate of change of velocity is nothing but acceleration. So we say that the charged particle is accelerated. When that is accelerated, then Maxwell electromagnetic theory says that that particle would radiate energy. And if that particle radiate energy, what will happen? Electron will lose energy, start losing energy, and it will, after some time, it will have zero energy and it will collapse into nucleus. The atom will collapse. Atom will collapse in this case. But we know that atom is stable. So, Rutherford could not explain the stability of atom. Could not explain. According to Rutherford model, the atom should have collapsed because the charged particle is moving towards the another charged particle and that will radiate energy in the form of electromagnetic waves and that will make the electron lose its energy and finally it will fall into the nucleus and atom will collapse. But this does not happen. Atom is stable. So Rutherford could not explain the stability of atom. And the second point was, Rutherford could not explain the discontinuous spectrum, discontinuous hydrogen spectrum, or we say discontinuous atomic spectrum. Atomic spectrum is discontinuous. It is in the form of these lines. But according to Rutherford model, this should be continuous. So we will study more about this second point in our next video when we take that in order to remove these points, to these drawbacks, to remove these drawbacks, Bohr postulated his atomic theory, where we will see that all these drawbacks were eliminated and that Bohr's atomic theory will be taken in my next video.